HarperCollins presents Hema Malini, Beyond the Dream Girl by Ram Kamal Mukherjee, read by Sumit Kaul. A note for listeners before we begin. Don't forget to download the enhanced PDF containing supporting material for this title from your audiobook provider. It contains Hema Malini's complete filmography and a chart detailing her family tree. Forward by Narendra Modi. I am delighted to know that the book Beyond the Dream Girl is being published on the life of noted actor and political leader Hema Malini ji. Hema ji has distinguished herself as one of the leading Indian actors of our times. Her cinematic brilliance has spanned several films through the various decades. Her many roles have connected and endeared her to a wide range of cinema lovers. The efforts of Hema ji to popularize Indian classical dances, particularly among youngsters, are deeply commendable. It is gladdening to note that the biography of Hema ji also covers her early years and how she gained a foothold in the film industry through hard work and dedication. Hema ji has also been an active BJP member for many years. She has served diligently in the Rajya Sabha and is currently serving in the Lok Sabha. I have found her extremely sensitive towards the development aspirations of the people of Mathura, her constituency. Once again, congratulations on the book, and may it further connect Hema ji to the lakhs of well-wishers she has in India and the world. Introduction. Dreams don't work out unless you work. If I was asked to choose the one enduring lesson Hema Malini left me with, it would be the above. Her aura had been described perfectly by Sanjeev Kumar when the late actor, after having worked in half a dozen films with her, declared, "Hema Malini is neither a goddess nor a saint, but she is someone who is worshipped for both qualities." When I decided to write my second book on her, this time an authorized biography, I was keen on exploring the person beyond the superstar. I was equally aware that I had my work cut out. Hema is an introvert and barely talks about her personal life. What added to the challenge was venturing into the same territory after nearly two decades. My first book on Hema Malini, Diva Unveiled, published in 2003, was a pictorial depiction of the actor's life. A cub reporter at that time, I remember how she had told me I was too young to take up the project. Moreover, veteran journalist and editor of Screen Weekly, Bhavna Somaya, was already writing her biography. I stuck to my resolve nonetheless. Although well received by film aficionados, Diva Unveiled, because of its pricing, ended up more a collector's item. But I have no regrets. The book helped me find a new lease of life in Bollywood, as well as recognition as an author. Over the last 15 years, I've had the opportunity to observe Hema's life from close quarters, from Seeta Aur Geeta to Baghban, from campaigning for Vinod Khanna in Gurdaspur to becoming an MP from Mathura, from being the dream girl to becoming the flag bearer for liberated, independent women. It has been a phenomenal life. Her transition from actress to director to politician to playback singer has been commendable. All the while, she has also been playing the role of a cultural ambassador through her immensely popular dance ballets. She continues to be one of the strongest proponents of classical dance and music in the country. However, in a career span of five decades, she has won the Filmfare Award just once. That says a lot about her PR skills. "I never had a PR person. I never partied, and I had to never ask for work. But now things have changed," she says. While interviewing her, I realized there is a lot that has not been written about her. And now, as she turns 70, she is probably in a position to drop her guard. Hema has always called a spade. Apart from her mind-boggling capacity to master new terrains, in this book she opens up, for the first time, on her childhood years, her unpredictable career graph, her unconventional life choices, and the steep, hard climb she has endured to get to where she is today, in complete harmony with herself. Hema's journey as a politician is probably one of the most interesting chapters in this book. From the Rajya Sabha to an elected BJP MP from Mathura, she has had a great run. "I want to serve the nation. Whatever I am today is because of the public. It's now my turn to do something for society," she says. She continues to be a well-loved name in political circles. From Sonia Gandhi to Atal Bihari Vajpayee, from Lalu Prasad Yadav to Narendra Modi, her popularity cuts across party lines. MP and Trinamool Congress Minister Derek O'Brien shared in jest an incident that took place at the Silver Jubilee celebration of HarperCollins India. Once, Hemaji's earring fell on the carpet of the Parliament corridor, and every minister, from the ruling party to the opposition, immediately fell on his knees to look for it. It shows her aura, even in politics. "Each time anyone asks me why I was writing another book on Hema, I ask back, why not? I had just taken a break from my editorial job at Stardust and had been working on my first fiction book, Long Island Iced Tea. It was also around this time that Swaroop Nanda, my friend and founder of Lead Start Publishing, connected me with Shantanu Ray Chaudhary, executive editor at HarperCollins India. There is so much more than just being a dream girl to Himaji's life. I am sure there are readers who want to know her story," he said when I broached the topic. "In all my years in the industry, I've rarely come across as passionate an editor as Shantanu, the man who walked me through this journey. Call it a miracle or divine intervention, things started falling into place. I came across Nushin Mawla, a young and talented girl from the City of Joy, who was of great help in making this book a possibility. Formerly a producer of a hugely popular television series on Hindi cinema, she was just the editor I was looking for. To review the same subject but through a new lens is never easy, and that's where Nushin played the part of staunch critic and sounding board. Don't be so possessive about your text. You need to tell a story, and ideally an interesting one," she kept saying. Many others played their part. Prabha Chakravarti, Hema's sister-in-law, helped me put together the facts painstakingly despite her pressing schedule. Hema's cousin, superwoman Prabha Raghavan, helped me with the images, allowing me access to some rare and exclusive collections. Isha Deol Takhtani and Ahana Deol Vora, Hema's lovely daughters, shared some previously untold stories on their relationship with their mother. I was also fortunate enough to interview Hema's colleagues, directors, producers, friends, and extended family members who were only too happy to talk about her. The only person missing in this picture was Hema Malini herself. Her political commitments and later a major road accident on the Jaipur highway made her virtually inaccessible. But I was willing to wait. When she realized how adamant I was, she finally relented. "You think people still want to read about me?" she asked. "This is for the new generation, those who have perhaps never watched your films," I told her. For the rest, it had been over 10 years since they last read about her. This time I wanted the world to know how much more there was to India's first female superstar. Moreover, this wouldn't be an ode. It would include the controversies, the challenges, and all that had made her journey thus far so inspiring. During the same conversation, I asked her, "Do you have a Facebook or Instagram account, Hemaji?" She looked at me and said, "No. Why?" I replied, "This is exactly why I want to write a book on you. Every wall stands on bricks of faith. For this book, I too have had my fair share. I thank my mentor, Nari Hira, the founder of Magna Publishing, for granting me access to the archives of Stardust, Showtime, Society, Savvy, and Diva Unveiled. Sonali Jafar Kotnis, my colleague and ex-editor of Stardust, thank you for suggesting my name to Mr. Hira for the coffee table book on Hema Malini. Vicky Idnani and his entire team, thank you for creating the cover image for this book. Bonita, thank you for being so clear in your vision. And Amrita and Bidisha in the editorial team at Harper for your meticulous work on the text. I could not have asked for more. My Baba, late Jaydev Mukherjee, and my Ma, Roma Mukherjee, for giving me a pair of wings to fly. I am eternally grateful. My wife, Sarbani Mukherjee, who stood by me like the rock of Gibraltar and also played the role of co-researcher in this mammoth task. I couldn't have done this without you. My brother, Krishna Kamal, for being my inner strength, my colleague, Chandrima Pal, for playing the role of an agony aunt, my four-year-old son, Rian, the perfect stress buster in the middle of mayhem, thank you all eternally. I would also like to thank Sukumar Pramanik, secretary to Hema Malini, for his contribution to the book. He has been associated with Hemaji for the last 15 years and has witnessed my journey too. And of course, Hema Malini, who believed in me till the end. Prologue. The story of Sujata. She is going to be called Sujata from today. Her current name is not good enough, declared the film producer to the stunned mother and daughter standing before him. As he languidly got up from the easy chair, their looks of astonishment didn't escape him. In fact, he smiled inwardly at their ignorance. It had been 7 years since Bimal Roy's Sujata had released. A powerful comment on the caste system, the film had moved its audience in unprecedented ways. The producer, who had watched the film 18 times, had been on the lookout for a face that would match the intensity of the film's titular character. His protege would take off from where Nutan had left. C.V. Sridhar, both mother and daughter had heard, was a formidable name in the Tamil, Hindi, and Telugu film industries. The man had spotted, handpicked, and offered to launch the career of young Hema Malini, an accomplished Bharatanatyam dancer, who was making quite a splash across the country with her stage performances. He met her orthodox Iyengar family and offered to launch their beloved daughter in a Tamil film. With just one caveat, her name would have to be changed. For Hema and her mother, Jaya Chakravarti, the fog of bewilderment took some time to lift. As they stared blankly, first at him, then at each other, and back again at him, they realized that his statement wasn't made to initiate debate. The decision had already been taken within the first 3 minutes of their meeting. Hema would be called Sujata from that day. The offer from Sridhar hadn't surprised them. Hema's concerts were receiving rave reviews and film offers had been pouring in from both the Hindi and Tamil film industries. Back home in Madras, however, the situation caused considerable strife. Her parents were divided on the matter and had stopped talking to each other. In all their married years, Ranga Ramanuja Chakravarti, better known by his official name Vengarai Sri Sailesha Ranga Ramanuja, BSR Chakravarti, and Jaya had never had such a huge disagreement. A deadlock of this kind was unheard of in the family. For the shy and intensely reserved Hema, the decision to take up Sridhar's offer had caused much distress. Films held no excitement for her. Dance had always been her one true love, and that's all she had really wanted to do. For someone who could barely introduce herself to strangers, the thought of facing the camera, performing with unknown men, and being pushed into a world of ostentation and glamour was nightmarish. I wasn't keen on joining films at all. Being shy, I was always petrified of exploring new avenues. And films, I didn't even want to think about them, she says. But it wasn't a decision for her to take. If you don't like the first film, you can opt out of this career, but you have to give it a shot, Jaya Chakravarti said. For her, the temptation was hard to resist. An accomplished artist herself, specializing in painting and classical singing, she was a strong-willed lady of considerable dignity and pride. A woman who ran the house with an iron hand and brought up her children almost single-handedly while her husband was busy at work, Jaya had a natural propensity towards wielding power. For Hema, she was a mother, a mentor, and her closest friend, a relationship that used to surprise many because it involved two equally strong, fiercely independent women. I kept telling myself, this would be my first and last movie, Hema reminisces. Mujhe actress nahi banna hai. If getting used to a new name overnight wasn't hard enough, the following day was kept aside for a photo shoot. Forced to wear a sari, a first for her, Hema's thin and lanky frame didn't make for a very pretty picture. I was looking thin and ugly as hell in that sari, but Sridhar insisted that I do the photo shoot in a sari and nothing else. Though my mother tried her best, the pleats kept coming undone. I looked clumsy. I wish they had asked me to wear a pavada, a half sari. But nobody cared about me or my choices at that point, she recalls. Over time, however, as days rolled into months and...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.